Hello, I'm Patty Simpson, and we're going to continue our lecture on function notation. So this problem leads us up to something called the difference quotient, which we'll use in the definition of a derivative in calculus, but this is just college algebra. So what we're going to do in this class is make sure that we can do the algebra involved in evaluating this. So just like our other problems that we've done, we're going to evaluate using this function notation. So in this particular problem, I've given you a quadratic, and in the first part, all we're going to do is evaluate our function at x. That's weird. I didn't put a number in there. Instead, I'm just giving you that expression x. All you do is everywhere you see an x, you put an x, or notice that we already know what f of x looks like. We know what it's equal to. F of x is just equal to that quadratic. Remember, we could make that a y. I'm just asking, what is y equal to if I'm leaving x in place there? In terms of x, what is y equal to? So we leave it alone. It's exactly the same as that. That's weird, Miss Simpson. Why are you having us write that down again? Just trust me. We're going to use that in a little bit. So that's part A. We did it. In part B, I asked you to fill in or to evaluate there at x plus h. So again, all we're going to do is take that expression and plug it in or substitute it in everywhere I see an x here. So instead of writing those x's, I'm going to write my parentheses. Everywhere I see that x. And then I'm just going to fill in with this x plus h in each of those places. So that I have x plus h and x plus h. And just like we've done before, now it's just making sure that we do the order of operations. We can't combine those, they're not like terms, so we're going to do our exponent first. And we must remember that what this means is x plus h times itself. And then we can distribute that out, or if you know that acronym FOIL, we can use FOIL there. Everything else I'm just going to leave alone. Here I'm going to go ahead and distribute that out so that I have x times x gives me x squared. X times h gives me that x times h. Now I'm going to distribute the h so that I have x times h or h times x. You know, with multiplication, 3 times 4 is equal to 4 times 3. So we can write it either way. Multiplication is commutative. So I can do that here too. I can write this as hx like this, or I could write it like this, xh. They're the same thing. Then I'm going to multiply the h times the h so that I end up with h squared. Now I'm going to distribute the negative 3 here so that I have negative 3x and negative 3h. Now I'm going to combine whatever like terms I have. Let's see if we have anything that's alike. There's not another x squared there. Oh, but there are two xh's here, so I could say 2xh. There's not another x squared, h squared. Not another x or h. So when I evaluate this function at x plus h, I get this big long thing here. Okay, so now part C actually uses both part A and part B. If you notice, this part right here, f of a, x plus h, we just did that. We just did that. Here it is. F of x plus h. We know what f of x plus h is equal to because we just did that part. This is equal to that. So instead of writing x plus h, or instead of doing this again, I can just replace that whole thing with this. X squared plus 2xh plus h squared minus 3x minus 3h plus 4. And then it asks me to subtract f of x. But again, we know what f of x is. We did that in part A, or it was just the given equation. That's what was given to us, was that function, f of x. So that's all it's asking us to do here, is to subtract that function, that f of x. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to subtract this whole function there. I'm going to erase part B, D for just a minute. We'll come back to that, just so I have room. So here I'm going to write x squared minus 3x plus 4. So I'm going to subtract that function. Now notice that I put it inside parentheses. That's because I'm subtracting the whole thing. And when I do that, I have to remember to distribute this minus sign to each one of the terms in there. So now it's just a matter of simplifying. I have this f of x plus h is this part. I'm subtracting the original function f of x, and now I'm just going to simplify it. So let me first do that distribution. So I'm not going to do anything here just yet. Just leave it alone. So this becomes a negative x squared. A negative times a negative makes that a positive. And then a negative times a positive there is a negative. Now I'm going to combine like terms. Well, notice this x squared minus that x squared is going to equal 0. And let's see what else can we combine. This negative 3x and that positive 3x, again, is going to equal 0. And then this 4 minus that 4 is going to equal 0. So I'm left with 2xh plus h squared minus 3h. So this function here minus our original function gives us 2xh plus h squared minus 3h. Now, part D finally leads up to something that we call the difference quotient. And again, you're going to use this in calculus, but here in college algebra, we just learned how to the algebra involved with it. So, again, notice this numerator part. It is the exact same thing that we had there in part C, where we took the f of x plus h minus the f of x. We already know what that is. Here it sits. So I know the answer to this. This is the same thing as that. So I'm going to go ahead and write that down. 2xh plus h squared minus 3h. And we're dividing that by h. Notice that there's no function talk here. There's no f in front of it. So this is just a variable. It's the variable h, simply the h. No function talk that time. Now I'm going to do some simplification. This fraction, we have to be careful, because we cannot just cancel out this h and that h. That's not okay. For instance, if I had, let's just pretend for a minute that I had 2 plus 3 over 2. Well, you know that the way we'd solve this is we'd say 2 plus 3 equals 5, and then we would divide it by 2 to make it 5 halves. Notice that that's not the same thing as if I just go, oh, look, that goes away. That's not the same thing. We can't do that. It's the whole order of operations thing we have to be careful with. So it's like we have a grouping symbol up on top. But we can do this. Back to my 2 plus 3 equals 2. Remember that when we add fractions, we find a common denominator, and then we add the numerator. Well, look at this. Couldn't I rewrite that as 2 over 2 plus 3 over 2? Because when I'm adding fractions, I would just keep my denominator and add my numerator. So I can break those fractions back up. We're going to use that to help us up here. And notice either way, this equals 5 halves. So let's do that here with our variables. We're just going to rewrite this as 3 different fractions, each with its own denominator. Now that we've done that, now this is just multiplication and division. So I can go ahead and say h divided by h is 1. And here I can say h squared, which remember is just h times h. You know, I could rewrite that as h times h. Well, one of those h's divided by that h again is 1. And then this h divided by that h is 1. So I'm left with 2x plus h minus 3. Now we could have just started with this. And this plugged in x plus h into our function, subtracted our original function and divided by h. But putting it in steps like this helps us to solve when we have a bunch of different steps. So tonight, just know that the A and the B are going to lead up to your C. You find your this part of your C in B, and you find this part in A or in the original question. Then you're going to use that as your numerator divided by H. Hope this helps. Thanks for watching.